Question number one. You need to wash that jacket. It looks really... 5 seconds. ¿No alcanzaron a contestar? You need to wash that jacket. It looks really... Yeah, very good. Dirty. It looks really dirty or dirty in British English. Alec, Brendalus, Martikis, and Perka. 100 euros for a t-shirt? That's expensive. That is too expensive because this is a negative sentence. Okay, for negative sentences, we use too for negative expressions. Eso es demasiado caro. Okay, Luz, go up in position. The sheer I am. Today is a birthday present from my sister. Very enough, close. This is present continuous. I am wearing present continuous. Okay, now Marta, go up one position. Volleyball is more exciting than football. Than football, very good. For comparisons, we use than. Okay, now Brenda, go up. Jack, karate. Does karate. Remember that for individual disciplines, we don't use play. Play is for game team, in team. We use do. And as we are talking about Jack, we have to use the third person, does. Jack does karate. Okay, now Lucy has the first place. Number six. Who's your favorite actor, of course? Okay. Same positions. Cristiano Ronaldo plays for a Spanish team, but he is... Portuguese, of course. Okay, same positions. You can borrow books from the schools. Library. In a library, you can borrow books. In a bookshop, you can shop, you can buy books. Same positions. We have lunch from 12:00 to 1:30 p.m. Break. We have a lunch break. Okay, everybody. Was correct. Same positions. Don't ask. I don't know the answer. Good. Don't ask me. Same positions again. We study tonight. Tomorrow we have a math test. Good, everybody was correct again. Now Alec has the first place. What time you get to school this morning? What time did you get to school this morning? So it was simple past. Just one. No puedes decir a qué hora llegas a la escuela esta mañana. A qué horas llegaste. Okay, just Perla. There is a big outside the town. They make bicycles there. There's a big factory because they make bicycles. So it's we are talking about a factory. Okay, same positions. I don't buy CDs. I music from the internet. Download. I download music. Download es bajar, descargar. I download. No podría ser listen, guys. Les recuerdo que este verbo siempre debe ir con to. No puedes decir I listen music. I listen to music. I listen to videos. I listen to CDs. I listen to the radio. Siempre, ¿eh? Si no tiene to, esa oración está mal. Siempre es listen to. And let's see, the third place is for Brenda. Congratulations, third place. The second one is for Oscar. Second place, and our winner, Luz, first place. Okay, great. Number four, Marta, and in fifth place, Perla. Okay, congratulations to everybody. Mira, al final otra vez Luz se lo se desbancó. Bien joué. Ok. Promedio de grupo 7. Hay que estudiar lo básico, ¿eh? Presente simple, pasado simple. 71%. Ok, good. So, we are gonna read. We are gonna read together. And while we are reading, you have to do the activity. Okay, match the pictures with the paragraph. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, please start the reading, Perla. Idioms. Understanding. Perla, are you there?
Ah, okay, teacher. Es que no escuché mi nombre.
Don't worry.
Understanding idioms.
Yeah, you have to read.
Idioms can be a problem for language learners. They often seem to make absolutely no sense at all. For example, imagine your English friend Sam tells you this math exam was a piece of cake. Do you imagine him at school sitting in front at his dresser with nothing but a pen to eat it with. In fact, they saying that the exam was really easy. It's important to learn those useful English idioms and knowing their originals helps you to remember them. There are stories of 3 English idioms.
Okay, please, Perla, repeat. Sweet. Sweet.
Sweet.
Sweet dessert.
Sweet. Sweet.
Saying. He's saying.
Saying.
Useful.
He's saying.
Useful. Full.
Use.
Knowing. Origins. Okay, just that. Thank you. Then, can you continue, please, Marta? If you ask.
Dijo Marta, teacher?
Yeah.
If you ask a friend to hang out, you might hear, "Sorry, I can't tonight. I'm feeling a little under the weather." It might sound like rain is coming, but really, it means that your friend feels sick. This expression comes from sailors who often go seasick when bad weather tosses the ship from side to side. The sailors went down to the bottom part of the ship, away from the storm and where the ship's rocking was gentler.
Okay, thank you. Then let's repeat here.
Here.
Yeah, remember, here. In present is here, in past is here.
Here, okay.
This is here, past, here, present time.
Here.
Sound.
Okay, here.
Sound.
Rain.
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 Came. This was another. Got physic. Gentle or gentle.
General.
Both are correct. Gentle it's American and gentle it's the British. Gentle.
General, gentle.
Yeah.
Gentle.
Yes.
Gentle.
Thank you. Continue, Oscar B.
If you have a difficult roommate, you might say, my roommate has loud parties every night, but last night was the last straw. They played music till 5 a.m. I'm moving out. A last straw is a final problem that makes someone take action. This expression is a short form of the phrase the straw that broke the camel's back. The idea is that even though a single piece of straw is very light, many pieces added together will be too heavy for the camel to carry.
Okay, thank you. Very good, Oscar. Just loud parties. And camel. Yeah. And loud. Can you repeat? Loud. Yeah, like in a loud voice. Okay, good. Then Brenda, C.
Where teacher?
Have you ever asked someone if
they know something, and they reply, that rings a bell. They are not hearing music. They mean that what you're saying sounds familiar, and they think they've heard it before. This idiom comes from the fact that the bells are used to remind people of many things. Traditionally, bells would toll for an important event, like a wedding. School bells telling that your class is starting. And even the alarm chime on your phone reminds you that it's time to get up.
Okay, thank you, Brenda. Ask. Yeah.
Ask.
Yes. La mayor parte de los verbos en pasado, recuerden que esa E no se pronuncia. Entonces, ask. Por eso es ask. Omito la E. Ask.
Reply.
Used. Lo mismo, la E no suena.
Reply.
Used. Y por último, esta que yo la pronuncié mal hace rato, si es correcto, es idiom. Idiom, tal cual se escribe. Idiom.
Idiom.
Yes.
Idiom.
Yeah. Good guys. Now, do you have vocabulary question?
Yes, me. What's the meaning for sailors?
Sailor, marineros.
For sailors? I don't know what's the meaning.
Marinero, sailor.
What is seasick?
Seasick, mareo. Le llaman la enfermedad del mar. Sí es mar y sí que es enfermo. La enfermedad del mar es cuando te sientes mareado. Sí, sí.
Teacher, whether toast.
Toast es brindar.
¿Para aquí?
¿Dónde estaba?
Toast. Whether toast. Aquí, aquí, en este, en este. ¿Ve mi cursor que se mueve?
No, no sé. No,
aquí
no
está.
Solo que le rayes.
¿No? Ah, ok.
ABC or in the introduction.
En A. A, 1, 2, 3, 4,
5. Ah, ok. You often got seasick when bad were toast. Ah, toast, aquí sería balancear. Toast the ship. When bad weather, toast the ship. Yeah. También este es brindar, toast. En este caso se refiere a que hace esto con el barco. Toast the ship. From side to side, yeah.
Y en el último renglón dice ships rocking. Ships rocking was gentle.
Ships rocking es el golpear del barco con rocas. Donde el golpeo donde los golpes con las rocas son más generosos, o sea que se sienten menos. The sailors went down, los marineros bajan a la base, a la parte de abajo del barco, to the bottom part of the ship, away, lejos, lejos de la tormenta, away from the storm, y donde el golpeteo con las rocas con el barco es más leve.
Okay. Now. The letter C. Word with the meaning for toll.
Toll, redoblar. Redoblar campanas. Toll es redoblar, el redobleo de las campanas. That's it. Okay, now tell me which match the pictures with the paragraph. So loose A, which picture match with A?
Number three.
Yeah, that's number three. Perla, B.
One,
do you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Yes, it's correct, okay. And the last one is obviously number two. No more questions about vocabulary, reading comprehension.
Teacher, in the paragraph C, en el penúltimo renglón, dice chime.
Chime, ajá. And the even alarm, el timbre. Let me see si es vibración. I think it's timbre. The alarm chime, el tono del teléfono. El ring, la campanada. Sí, el ring de la alarma. Yeah. El sonido de la alarma.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Let's go to the next exercise.
¿Qué significa?
Ajá.
¿Qué significa la frase "the straw that broke the camel's back"?
Where is it?
En la B. The straw, donde dice "a shore from the frost, the straw that broke the camel's back".
Ah, es como la gota que derramó el vaso en español, esta frase. La gota que derramó el vaso. Literalmente, straw es carga o popote. La carga que rompió, dice aquí, la joroba, la espalda del camello. Este es un proverbio. Nosotros tenemos la gota que derramó el vaso. Es la misma. The straw that broke the camel's back.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, teacher.
Yeah, you're welcome. So in part B, you have to read the article again and correct the false statements. Please check if they are true or false. And if they are false, you have to rewrite. You have to rewrite the sentence with the correct information. Got it?
Teacher, what's the meaning? Guess.
Adivina. Guess. Adivinar.
Teacher, ¿qué cree que pueda mandar el texto por... for WhatsApp?
Okay, let me see.
Idiom, if you understand each word. Pero yo pienso que esto es incorrecto porque tú no puedes adivinar el significado de una frase. ¿Cómo se puede traducir idiom de una frase si tú entiendes cada palabra?
So, ¿qué cambiamos aquí entonces?
Yo no estoy de acuerdo.
¿Qué habría que cambiar entonces?
You cannot.
Yeah, you cannot.
You can't.
Exactly, just that. Just a word. Solo tienen que cambiar una palabrita. You can't. You can't guess the meaning of an idiom if you understand each word. No, that's not possible. What do you have in number two, Oscar?
Yo entendí la guía distinta. Yo le puse... yo cambié como que la última parte que estaba mal, porque decía "when they hear shooting". Y yo le puse "when they hear rings from a bell".
Yeah, that's correct. Okay. In the past, people knew about important events when they hear shouting. No, when they hear bells. When they hear bells, or when they hear bells ringing, that's also correct. Very good. Number three, Luz.
A camel falls down if it has to carry too much heavy.
Too much heavy? No. Which word? There's a word that we have to change. Which word do we have to change? Any idea, guys?
Too much straw.
Yes, very good. No water. We are not talking about water. We are talking about straw. Yes. Recuérdense que podemos decir que es carga, straw o paja, porque straw significa popote. Entonces también significa paja. Too much straw. That's the answer. Too much straw. And the last one, Brenda.
Teacher,
sailor used to feel sicker when they went to the bottom of the ship. It's maybe sailor went down.
No, because it's the same. Went down and went to the bottom. It's the same.
I changed and they used to sailors went down.
No, that's not the answer. Porque eso es lo mismo. Went down es lo mismo que went to the bottom. Went down is bajar.
I don't know.
Any idea, guys? ¿Los demás que cambiaron? No.
No, teacher, no lo hice.
Okay.
No.
When that weather closed the ship.
No. A ver, leanla bien que dice. Sailors used to feel sicker when they went to the bottom of the ship. ¿Qué dice en español la frase?
Los marineros usaban su sentido de...
No, solían. Used to, solían.
¿Usar su sentido de enfermedad?
No, solían sentirse...
Sentirse enfermos.
Ajá.
¿No? Cuando ellos iban como en el al frente, ¿no? ¿Borom?
No, bottom es en la parte de abajo. De bottom. Top, bottom.
Okay.
Cuando ellos se iban a la parte de abajo del barco.
Cuando iban abajo.
Según la lectura, los marineros se sienten más enfermos, dice aquí, sicker. Se sienten más enfermos, se sienten peor cuando ellos se van a la parte de abajo del barco. No, según la lectura es lo contrario. Se iban a la parte de abajo del barco cuando se sentían mareados. Entonces era para sentirse mejor. So, la palabra que tenían que cambiar es sicker por better. Los marineros solían sentirse mejor cuando se iban a la parte de abajo del barco. Porque ahí recuerden que dice la lectura que se siente menos el golpeteo del barco con las rocas. Sailors used to feel better. Yes? Okay, any question?
No, teacher, any question? No question.
Are you sure?